And welcome back to Let's Play Blightfall. On last episode, we went ahead and made our first little farm here. And it's coming along nice. We've got peas, we've got broccoli, cotton, wheat, and barley. And we've got room for a lot more, and we can actually add to it over here if we wanted to as well. Could probably go right out to about there if we wanted to. But we'll get to that. We've also got darkwood and ghostwood going on. We've got some maple growing, and jungle, and birch tree. So we're in really good shape, actually, for this stage of the game. What I'd like to do real quick is create a second chest. And this is definitely going to be something that we're going to be dealing with a lot in this game, is how do we store things? You know, what's the most efficient way to store things? And, yeah, okay, good. Keep in mind, you can open chests when they're above or when they're below transparent blocks, but you cannot if it's a solid block. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually take all the plant and food-related items and put them in this other chest. And I'm going to keep all this miscellaneous stuff from other things in this chest. Okay. Fine. I'm going to put our orchard trees and then our regular trees, then our flowers, then our seeds, and then our thing, and then our food, and then our wood. Okay, so that is good. Actually, that should probably come down here as well. We will probably create a separate storage for wood altogether. By the way, I might strip this tree of its lower ring. If I were lucky enough to get a silverwood sapling out of that, that would be amazing. But I really don't need this. It's more decorative at this point. And it's just getting in the way of where I'm going to be placing organizational tools and machines and things that I'm going to need. So I'm just going to strip this layer out. And it looks like I'm not going to be ecstatically lucky and grab a silverwood sapling out of that. But if you wanted to, you could actually chop this tree down, with one exception of the aura node that's in the middle of it, which we'll get to that eventually. That's fine. I'm going to leave that tree up for now. Ghostwood is a really cool looking wood, and we're going to probably use it for furniture and stuff eventually, but it's not particularly strong like our dark wood pickaxe. By the way, one thing you should probably do in general is always have repair material on hand, such as that. I'm going to grab just a little bit of food just in case I run out. I'm going to do a fairly extensive mining trip now. Let me grab that and some sticks. Got 36 torches. Actually, I'm gonna grab that. Gonna make a crafting table that I'm gonna bring along with me. I'm gonna create some more planks and that. Oh, what the hell? Let's just bring the whole stack. May need it all. May need none of it. We'll see. Okay, let's do this. So I go over to my little mining shaft. By the way, I have a second sort of in a carved out area that I could connect up with this. That actually is not the worst idea in the world. Let's do that real quick. One thing you can look at your mini map on, it keeps track of underground activities, but it kind of rounds it. So as long as you're within 8 or so Y levels, it's gonna be showing you what is happening underground as well. There we go, connected that right up there, so that's nice. We'll probably expand on that later, make it into something useful. We're definitely going to be adding to these stairs eventually, but for now, I'm just going to do that. And as long as I do 3 at a time, that's going to be fine as far as altitude goes. So this is a little bit more of a complicated way of mining that you can mine with less less blocks cut out at one time. Like, you can do 3, but I'm doing 4 so I can make room for those stairs eventually. I might want some more of that dirt eventually too. By the way, with the tinker's tool, if you have torches to the right in your inventory of your tinker's tool, you can right click and put those torches down. Really cool feature. Big time saver. Thank you. Okay. Whoa. That is why we don't mine straight down in Minecraft, right there. So that is quite a chasm. That is quite an opening. And there is an abandoned mine shaft right there. That is awesome. And we got a little eerie music. So what I'm going to do, I think, is just block that off real quick. And I think I'm going to try to work our way down this direction. And see if that doesn't get us a little bit farther down before it opens up into a cave this time. Ooh, and we've got some iron. And I can actually harvest that with this darkwood axe, which I will. And that... Ooh, neat. Okay, so this appears to be a ravine intersected by a mine shaft. I really want to be careful standing on the edge like that, because if there was a mob or even if I got taint flu, it could be bad. So I'm going to go ahead and create some light here. But boy, that is neat. And it would be convenient to get down there and see if I can go that way. But either way, I need to get down lower so I can get through that area. By grabbing this iron, by the way, it told me something about additional metal materials that I didn't know before. So let's just keep mining downwards. I'm not a huge fan of keeping it on the edge like this. In fact, I think I'm going to add some protection along here. Okay. By the way, if you put torches, as I mentioned last episode, they are transparent blocks, and they will prevent the taint from creeping in. And we've got water. I'm okay with destroying that. Oops. And our pickaxe is almost done for, but that's okay, because we brought repair material. I think I'm going to construct a staircase down there with our additional schist. This is annoying that you have to destroy this taint when you do stuff like this, but just get used to it. Okay, so I probably should have gotten one lower there. That lava I'm going to need eventually down there, by the way, so that's great. By the way, even though I've played this mod pack before, I've never started at this location before, so this is all new to me as well. And there's going to be, most of this mod pack is going to be new to me, because frankly, I've just played around with it. I haven't actually done a lot of, I never finished it or anything like that, so most of this is pretty new to me as well. Okay, so I'm going to put a couple torches, prevent some of this taint from getting anywhere, and to remind myself of where my exit is, always useful. By the way, just so everybody knows, I am not playing with hardcore mode on, as if it, you know, I'm not sure if anybody was wondering about that, but you know. Sometimes this is ostensibly designed as a hardcore map, so I just wanted to be clear about that I'm not using hardcore questing mode right now. Okay, so there's our stairway, and fortunately there's no mobs around, apparently. By the way, for those of you who've watched my Terraformercraft series, that one is still very much ongoing, even though I haven't posted an episode for a while. I'm definitely wanting to do more with that before I finish out that series, including advanced metal stuff. Okay, so we've got some tin. Excellent. Okay, I can definitely mine that up. And tin is used to alloy bronze with copper. Alloy with copper to get bronze. Now, by the way, as you can see, I've mined backwards, and I'm still under the sphere of my dome, so I don't have taint here, which is great. And actually really convenient. I'm going to repair my axe real quick. Okay. Grab these, I guess. Sometimes it's useful to leave these in place, because they are transparent blocks. Oh, shit. Wow, I did not die. I Wow. Okay. Oh, okay. You need to not be around me right now. I need to eat and not die. Oh, that was a mistake. I don't know why I didn't remember that there was a giant gap in the middle of that, but I didn't. And thank God there's not, like a tendril or something right here. And actually, thank God that there's a little patch of non-tainted land here, too. That was unexpected and nice. What is that? Is that... silver. Can I get silver? Yes, I can. Okay, I'm going to grab that. So far I've grabbed silver, iron, and tin. All pretty awesome stuff. Maybe it wasn't such a bad thing that I fell so far. Obviously, your mining speed is reduced when you're standing in water. Okay. So, incidentally, I've got 5 iron, 2 silver, 2 tin. And I really would like to probably go back upstairs. That is just creepy. Dark cavern that you probably can't even hardly see, but I think the easiest way to get back up there, honestly, is to just pull up from right about here. Ooh, there's black granite down here too. Let me go ahead and just pull up if I have the resources to do that. Let me see. Start out with just basic cobblestone. Let's just do that. This does create a method to get down there, I suppose, too, without falling now. I have exactly 21 of those, which is exactly the height that I fell. Interesting coincidence. Okay. I could use these fence gates, too, by the way. Or these fences, because I'm going to need them for a couple things. Animal corralling, obviously, and some other stuff. Ooh, there's chalk. That's a new stone type. Oop, little lag. Very cautious here. Okay, let me just grab one more of those. Okay. And I'll turn that in later. Okay. This is salt, by the way. You're gonna need this for cooking. And I think a couple other things, but especially cooking. So, these webs can turn into string, which is useful. We're gonna make a hammer eventually, and it's gonna speed up this mining process a lot. But for now, oops, that's aluminum, and I cannot harvest the aluminum. I really could use that aluminum. I really need copper first, because copper alloy to bronze, and then I can harvest the aluminum. Or I can make a smeltery and make iron stuff as well. Okay, and then, by the way, we're going to start seeing these, too. These are shards. That's for Thaumcraft stuff, and we're going to need those eventually, so I'm going to grab any that I see. I love this early part of the game because I don't have to worry about a cluttered inventory. I have so much free space because I've only got 3 tools on me right now, and I'm gonna have like 7 tools, and it's just gonna be taking up all my inventory. A little bit more gravel. Not really that interested in the gravel. Although it does open up something here. I'm kind of using the mine shaft as a pre-dugout exploration chamber. I'm really looking for one thing in particular right now, and that is copper. If I could find me some copper, that'd be amazing. But while we're here, let's grab these shards as well. Eventually, I'm going to level this. Oh, this is good. Certus quartz is useful for two reasons. One, it's a material in and of itself that's fairly hard. I think it's the same level of hardness as the pickaxe that I'm currently using. So I could use that to make something like a sword. Boy, there's a lot of it here. Or I could enhance my mattock or whatever, but I could also use it as a modifier to make something, give something the sharpness modifier, which means it does more damage, or like a sword, for example, does more damage, or a crossbow bolt. So it's a good weapon modifier. And I'm definitely gonna grab as much of it as I can while I'm down here. This is a huge deposit of it. The reason, by the way, that I chose to mine westward initially is because I know that, at least in my previous playing of this mod pack, that the Prometheum, or that we've read about a little bit, is found in that direction, not this direction. So Prometheum is kind of a copper substitute, and it's great because you don't have to... Copper is really rare in this mod, but obviously, if I could find copper, that would be great too. So the problem with copper is that it merely satisfies a quest, namely to find iron. And I can use the iron to create ingots, but I cannot use the iron to create tools yet, because in order to use iron, you have to have a smeltery in this mod pack, which is a great challenge. It's an additional thing that the mod creator did that I think is great. It's an additional challenge, something to make it a little bit more rewarding when you actually accomplish things. Okay, that's a trip downstairs that I don't necessarily want to take. Okay, let me close that. Let me just go back up. Okay, you know, I'm going to not go this. Well, there's a chest down here. I could actually, that chest could be, could contain some good things. The thing is, I'm starting to run low on inventory space, and I really think I should focus on, that is not a chest, never mind. But I think I should focus on copper. I don't know if you can even see this, guys, but there. I'm actually surprised they didn't install the dynamic lighting mod, which allows you to hold a torch and see everything using just your held torch. Yeah, there we go. So that's where I started out. Basically, I'm just looking for copper at this point. I really have two viable options. I can either find copper around here, or I can keep mining westward until I find Prometheum or copper. If I'm going to mine westward, though, I'm going to keep going downwards eventually, because then I'll be low enough for rarer ores, and I can at least start tracking where those are located. For example, rarer ores. This is yellowrite. I'm going to need that for power creation eventually, theoretically. But it is completely beyond my ability to harvest right now. On the other hand, there is nothing wrong with getting all of this iron, because I'm going to use every drop of it. Iron is by far the most useful and ubiquitous metal in the game, and in this particular mod pack as well. So don't hold back in getting some iron. I think in the future I might do a lot of mining off-screen, but I'm doing this first one with you guys. I always put my torches on the right side of caves. Some people use the left. I use the right side of caves. That way it reminds me of where I've been and tells me which direction I need to go to get out. And, you know, when I first started doing that, I would still get lost all the time, but you just got to learn to trust yourself. If you do that consistently, you will always find your way out, or at least back to a point where you can kind of piece together where you've been and where you came from. I've got a lot of coal now, too, which is going to be really handy one way or the other. Okay. I think I'm going to go back to where I started. Let's just grab this air shards real quick, I guess. But then I'm going to go back to where I started and head a little bit west. A lot of this is going to be dictated by hunger and inventory space. And I've got 4 extra slots. Make that 3. I'm going to grab these earth shards, too. And this iron here. Oh, there's a lot of iron. I wish I could, well, I don't really care. I don't need that yellowrite. Yellowrite, cinnabar, most of the salt I'm leaving behind for now. Cinnabar is useful in Thaumcraft. It's mercury, essentially, quicksilver. Amber, same thing, useful in Thaumcraft, but not for anything that I need right now. It's not useful as a building material, for example. God dang it, I hate these little slime guys. Okay, what is that? That's more aluminum, which I cannot yet harvest. I need to... There's a lot of aluminum in here. Oh, there's tin. I'll grab this tin. The tin will be useful if I can just find copper. But, it's not useful right now. This salt, okay. I'm gonna leave... I'll just grab that one. Okay, let's go back to where I started. And let's find a way to keep going westward, how about, if possible. Of course, I keep saying I'm gonna go back to where I started, and then I keep not going back there. Ooh, there's sandstone. That's neat. Where am I located on the map? I'm under the ocean, so... And there's potash, by the way. Potash is... I don't even know what it's used for. We'll look that up sometime, but... I remember that from my first time playing through this. And that's broken, so let's just go back the way we came. Interestingly enough, this mod pack retains the original Minecraft music, which is cool. Nope, that's not right. Where did I... How did I get down to this? I think it was over here, maybe? Yeah. Okay, go up this way. Oh, shoot. Oh, okay, well, lost that one. Oh, shoot, look at my health. Yikes, I desperately need to get a non-tainted area. I might die, guys. One thing that I do, okay, that's not gonna work. When I get to this low health, I just dig in a wall somewhere and hang out there until I heal up, because there's no taint when you dig out these fresh spaces, and you can actually put torches to prevent it from coming in. Running low on torches, by the way. I'm okay with that. Oops, actually, I don't need those sticks. I can just use... Here, that's easy enough. Problem solved. Eventually, I'm going to make a backpack and a... eventually, I'm going to make a knapsack and possibly some other storage devices that are useful. But I don't have that yet. Might as well mine some of this stuff out while I'm waiting to heal up. Yep, there it is. Okay. I probably just better stay here. Okay, so I hope this episode isn't too boring. I know it's just mining, but mining, especially this early transitionary stage of the game, is very important. So I need to grab as much mine useful material as I can. All this iron will be used. I guarantee it. It's just I can't use it yet. It is that functionally important that I'm just grabbing it almost at any cost. I very nearly died just now, so that should tell you how important this mining trip really is. By the way, I might as well, the reason I brought this along, the whole point was to craft stairs out of my schist. Might as well get that going. Okay. There's a pretty safe little cove I can come into and heal if I need to. Okay, so anyway, I had come from this direction, I believe. I need to get back over there, is what I'm trying to do. So, that torch is not helpful. This looks promising. Yes, okay, there is a torch that... Nope. How about this? Is this right? No. Okay, that's not it. Gosh, I don't remember how I got down to here. Did I fall? I remember coming through a little place where I might have fallen, or I built a little makeshift staircase. Goodness. Well, maybe I'll just mine through the wall. Why don't we do that? That'll both avoid additional taint, and it will get me where I need to go. Um, I don't really know why I'm mining these rails. I'm not going to be using them for like a minecart system in the near future. In fact, this particular mod pack, there's really not a lot of point to having a minecart system because there's teleporters. It might be kind of fun and cool, but it's not needed or useful. Okay, I should be breaking through this wall any moment now. Great, can't mine. Yeah, I can't mine that. And I wouldn't want to anyway, because it's just more inventory space I don't want to deal with. Okay, perfect. Okay, I think we're back finally to where I was. Yes. I don't mind digging around in this area because there's no taint, but once I get into the taint, I really should be conservative about how far I go, make sure I'm always within recovery distance. I'm actually surprised I haven't found any mine carts yet. All right, well, let's try. Where's that giant staircase I just came down? Oh, boom, there it is. Glad I came this way. Okay, so this copper is going to be what we need. And frankly, I'm not sure if it's going to be enough all by itself. I may need more to get going. In fact, if I had this plus Promethium, it would be ideal, because then I could turn in both quests. In fact, I may avoid turning in the quest just to use the copper for what I'd like to use it for, as opposed to what the quest book is going to tell me I should use it for. Woo, that was running. But that's great. I'm glad I found that. That is essentially what made this mining trip worthwhile. Yeah, I'll go ahead and grab some of this. Hopefully it's not as big of a deposit as the last one. I upgraded my level from my pickaxe, so that is good. That is regular Sirtis quartz, not charged quartz. For those of you who may be familiar with what is it called? Mine Factory, maybe, or Thermal Dynamics, I can't remember, but one of the two uses these crystals very extensively. And I've got a second stack of them going on now. That's great. You know, I'm going to leave that for another time. Okay. Ugh, God, this iron. Once I get a full stack of iron, I'm going to stop mining iron. I'm glad that it's common. It's just that it, with limited equipment like I have right now, it doesn't make a lot of sense to be screwing around that much with iron until I can actually use it to make things that I need. Okay. So let's, what I'm kind of sort of backdoor hoping for right now is a mine cart. Alternatively, definitely more copper. Like, copper would be so useful right now if I could find just two or three more copper, especially like three more, I think would be enough to turn in the quest and to advance my technology level. Ow. Okay, Mr. Oh, I don't want that. Okay. And we've got this tainted soil. I should probably look up in the book what level copper is found at, because I don't want to be like mining all around when there's no copper at the altitude that I'm at. I'm going to jump inside this wall real quick. Heal up. By the way, some of these blocks are easier to mine than others, and chalk is very easy to mine. Okay, I did end up taking that. Alright. Throw that out. I could grab this, well, two things. Okay, there's a bone here, which is, I'm going to throw out that string. And then this granite. Now I'm gonna grab the granite so I can turn in the quest, but that's it. I'm not gonna grab any more than I need to turn in the quest. And then the bone is useful for another type of igneous granite. I just need one, okay. Bone is useful. It's a xenobiology quest line. And yeah, so those we can turn in to get reputation points in the xenobiologist quest line. And that's great. That's useful. Okay. Okay, let's finally go back to where we were. I love how clean this feels. Like, this rock type, like, some of these smoother rock types just feel so clean. Like, soapstone is another one. This one is blue schist, which feels very clean. I just love how clean they feel. Okay, and so that's the... You know, many of us will recognize this as the starting room in a mineshaft. This is the origin room, so that's cool. I just love how clean this feels in here. Okay, let's go back to the aluminum. Okay, this is kind of where we started. And in fact, I think our path upwards, upstairs is, where is it? That's right up here. So that is how we get back up. But I'm gonna go over here just briefly and see if I can make any progress going west. Again, placing my torches on the... Ooh, there's an accompanying shaft. Placing torches on the right side to remind myself which direction I came from is the way to go. There's a giant slime there. By the way, you see that big red question mark on the minimap? That is probably a taint tendril that is down here in the cavern with me, which is about the creepiest thing you can imagine. Taint tendrils are bad enough on the surface. They're even worse in cave systems because they are... in a confined space, and they will kill you very quickly in this context. Okay, there we go. Look at all that taint. That looks disgusting on that granite. Again, I am almost exclusively now on the hunt for copper and moving westward. So I'm going to go back up to here. What's down there, actually? Okay, well, that's neat. It looks so cool in this granite. Ocean shards, what is that? Is that gold? Or is that iron? I don't even know. That might be gold. No, it's just iron. It looked like gold from above the water, but I'm pretty sure it's just iron. Okay. So that's where we came from. I could get those fire shards, but I don't really want to right now. Maybe this is the best way to go. On the other hand, maybe it's not. See, I'm pretty sure there might... Yeah, there's that tendril. Oops, yep. See, he would kill me if I went that way. So I'm definitely not going to go that way. Let's go back up to the bridge. Is that gold? That's yellow, right? So I wouldn't mind getting some gold either, because that would be kind of a way I could do a workaround on the smeltery system that would allow me to avoid having to do this copper stuff. So I guess... Gold, copper, and promethium are really the main things that I'm looking for right now. Okay, looks like there's a bit of a dead end here, but that's okay. So I'm probably going to stop mining iron when I get to a full stack, if I get to a full stack this episode. Okay, so it looks like we've uncovered another side to this shaft. That's great. Okay, so let's just keep going. I should have looked at the map. Hold on. Where are we? Are we way over here already? Okay, yeah, we're over here. And frankly, if I could get to about here, that would be where the Prometheum kind of starts, I think. So I'm just going to keep going. It's a relatively peaceful route for now. Could get the entropy. Try to avoid falling down there. Oh, copper. Okay, I think that is a game changer. Build myself a little platform here. And we're gonna... Oh, let's see here. Can I just do that? Okay. I think, though, I really should probably put something under that. By the way, with the taint on it, the granite stays in place. It doesn't follow the normal gravity situation that we are used to in Minecraft. Oops, okay, I definitely want to go one lower than that. Okay, that should be good. Okay. So... there. That's what I meant to do. Okay. Let's just do it. Let's just get out of here. Okay, so I got that one. It's 5. Oh, shoot. Oh, boy. Cave spiders. Yikes. See him on the map, but he's not here yet. That is something we probably want to avoid, is the cave spiders. So... got my 5 copper. I'm not sure if there's an additional. Probably worth checking. So if I can get one more copper, a single additional piece of copper, I could just leave and be set. Yeah, I'm not seeing any. It's probably... normally copper spawns in little chunks of 2 or 3, and there are just 2 in that one, so I really should keep going. Okay. That's okay. This taint stuff, you have to kind of find which side of it allows you to knock it off, because you can only knock it out. Oh, whoop, there we go. You can only knock it out from one particular side at any given time. Okay, so we've got our 7 copper now, and that is all we need to get where we need to go, but since I'm down here, and since I'm already made it this far, oops, let's just keep going with this path. You know, I am getting some good resources, and whoa, shit. Okay, get out of here. Okay, so on second thought, the only way I'm going to make it past this is if I block his view. Okay, I don't need that one so much. I need that one. Okay, so that blocks the view of that tendril guy. Okay, that seems to have worked. Okay, perfect. Whoa, that is a big cavern there too. Looks like I'm once again over time. So thanks for sticking around if you stuck around this long. I may break my rule and I may edit this episode just a little bit. Okay, so I made some additional torches there. Yeah, it's a big open space. Some iron there too, but I think I'm just gonna dig right into here. Taint is annoying. Okay, so I think what I'll do is I'll just dig a little bit so it's clear, you know, there's a path forward for me in this direction, but I will actually head back very shortly. Okay, so, whoops. Yeah, because I definitely want to get over there so I can get some additional ore types, but I'm not there yet. By the way, I'm at altitude 32, which is good, but I probably should go lower if I want to get rarer ores, both in this biome and in the next one. So maybe I'll start maneuvering in that direction. I think I probably want to be around 20 or lower. Okay, so there's more cave stuff. And I think I'm going to just avoid that for now. So I'll stay at this altitude, but I'll keep going lower gradually. This is a nice straight shot though, at least. So I know that I'll have a really good path to get over to the other side. You know what, guys? I've been going for a while. I appreciate you sticking around. I know that this particular episode it got a little bit boring. I'm going to work on not allowing that to happen in the future. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to keep going off screen as far as I can before it gets a little treacherous or before I get to where I want to go. And then I'll just join you back at base after I come back off screen, okay? I'll see you back there. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to the next episode here on Let's Play Blightfall.